First, I'd like to say it's great to be in France. Such a appreciative readership. It's awesome. So the painter in English is about a expressionist painter from Taos, New Mexico, Jim Stegner, who's a very, very talented painter. And he suffers a tragedy, which I won't tell you because I don't want to give it away, but he suffers a terrible tragedy, the worst that you can suffer. And he moves up to a little town in rural Colorado, western Colorado, very small town surrounded by mountains, orchards running along a river. And he decides to try and find some peace there. He loves to fly fish. He finds great connection with nature, fishing. And he wants to just go back to quiet life, to painting, to healing. And he's driving up this little dirt road on this canyon along his favorite creek to go fishing, and he sees a hunting guide beating a horse to death. And he intervenes and he kills the guy and saves the horse, and basically. And so the book is about what happens to his life and his art after this killing. And it's told through the art, so every chapter is a catalogue raisonné of a painting. So it will say, Horse and Crow, Oil on Linen, 20 by 30 inches, collection of the artist. That's every chapter. So you follow the story through the work. This is based on a real painter who was my dear friend and my fly fishing companion for about 10 years in a little valley in Colorado. He's a very famous painter. And oftentimes I would come over to pick him up to go fishing and he'd be painting and I'd watch him paint. He was an exuberant painter. He painted like I wrote, which is to say, when he approached the canvas, often he never knew what he was going to paint, unless he had a commission, one special commission. But he would make a palette that would fit his mood and just begin painting. And he painted very fast. And the paintings have a lot of life and humor. And so I write like that. I begin with the first line, and I listen to the music of the language, and I follow the music of the language into the story, just the way my character painted. And so it was very easy, in a way, to write about this painting because it was the same process. I grew up with the canon, the American literature canon. I loved Hawthorne, Melville. I loved Emily Dickinson. I loved Mark Twain. I loved Hemingway and Faulkner. I loved Edith Wharton. I loved the canon. But then as I began to write fiction, I became more and more inspired by South American writers like Aira, who is a brilliant, crazy writer in Argentina, like Mutis from Colombia, who wrote this fantastic novel, The Adventures and Misadventures of McCroll. I became inspired by people like Murakami in Japan, people who were really pressing the limits and experimenting with what is real and what is not real. And so for me, that gives me my inspiration. And then oddly also, the ancient dynastic poets of China. These are my greatest inspiration, these guys who wrote about nature so beautifully and were in some ways aficionados of loss. They wrote about loss very succinctly in ways that I think are very powerful.